Hello and welcome to this concept tutorial of moving and rotating game objects from the same script. This is a rotating one and this is a moving one. We are applying these changes with mouse press to any point on the screen. The name of the script is Steer and Move. The owner is a target for rotation action and there is a public reference to a game object that we will be moving with mouse drag. In this case, it is this ship. There is also two variables to control the movement and rotational speed. Of course, at the end, you can divide these into two separate scripts and control them from each other or an external script. But to keep it simple with the tutorial, separate two game objects will be controlled from the same script. And for the variables, as the name suggests, move speed for movement and rotation speed for rotation. If I were to increase move speed, the ship would move crazy fast and float out of the rug. Yes, you guessed it right, it is a ghost ship, that is why it also floats directly left and right above the water. And if I were to change rotation speed, the steer will rotate crazily over the slower movement. You can tweak these values however you like. I want to have your attention to the environment a little bit. Here we have four spawners spawning these rugs. Inner spawners spawn smaller rugs and vice versa. All the models you see here from Kenny's Pirate Asset Pack, which is linked down in the description. And the game objects are the children of the camera and move thanks to camera's move forward behavior. There's also a plane that holds the fog. If I remove it, it doesn't look as good. And if you have other solutions regarding this, please share with me. Yes, this was planned to be runner game for a gem that I did not iterate on. But I like the first person view of the controller and controlled vehicle view and wanted to create a tutorial on that. This is mostly a concept tutorial, but there is one trick you can use. If the movement and rotational axis is not aligned with workspace, this still works as intended. Ship moves left, right, and steel wheel rotates as expected. And this is done at one point, which I will touch on in the code. Let's start it. Here is a public reference to game object that we will be moving, translation target. A reminder, owner of this script is the game object that we will be rotating. Here, speed multitudes for setting the speed representations of the actions. Move speed for movement and rotation speed for rotation. Now we are ready to inspect how this behavior works. First, we check whether the player pressing on left mouse button. And hey, this holds for touch input as well. Also, you can change these with touch controls if you target mobile. If not, you can continue with mouse input. If the mouse button is pressed, then we are ready to move and rotate. First, we store mouse's X positional change in horizontal plane, and the value is taken from input get axis mouse x call. By using this horizontal value and applying speed multitudes, we amplify rotational and movement speeds. First, we rotate the owner of this behavior with rotate function from it is transfer. Here, we give it a rotation axis. This object is expected to be rotating around its z axis, so we use transform forward. If your game object to be rotated around another axis, you should change this with the corresponding one. Then, rotation angle calculated as a multiplication of speed variable and horizontal mouse change. Higher these values, faster the game objects rotate. Here we are at the trick part of this tutorial, related to variable for rotate function. In default, it is set to space.self, and it causes problems when we want our movements to be flexible around coordinate systems. Like I showed you before, if I rotate my movement direction not aligned with the world space and set this to space.self, I will be seeing unwanted behavior. If you ask why, the axis we give to this rotation is in world space. To have the movement compatible with the direction, we should align their spaces by setting this cost relative to variable to space world. In default, this variable is set to space.self, so you need to specify the value from here. Now we rotate the donor. It is time to move the translation target, this time using translate function of it is transform. Here we also set the relative to variable to space world because for the translation direction we use the object's transform right direction. Again, we amplify the direction with mouse position change and speed multitude. Here we have a minus sign and the reason is that the positive direction of the screen space and the game object's coordinate system is looking at opposing directions. To align the movement with mouse movement, we are reversing the direction by putting a minus sign in front of the direction. And with that point, the circuit walkthrough and this tutorial has finished. Hope this will be helpful in your projects. And if there was a point not clear, please let me know in the comments down below. If you like this video, please give it a like and subscribe for more videos. I kind of like this setting, and if you're interested, in the future, we can go through how a ship would move physics-based or wouldn't be able to pass the rocks. Let me know what you think. And that's it for now. I hope to see you in the next explorations, and bye-bye!